Fr Hugh Mackenzie explores the historical developments in science and considers how Catholic thinking has failed to engage with the challenge of modern science.
Particularly in the 19th century, as the new science, experimental science, was kicking in, being used more and more, being very successful. Still, most prominent scientists, whether it's Pasteur or right through to Father Lemaître, who discovered the Big Bang, have found it perfectly harmonious to believe in their faith and to believe in science. However, those numbers are becoming less. There's less prominent Catholic scientists today than there were in the past. That should maybe raise alarm bells.
If you actually look at the last few centuries since experimental science came in the 17th century,
it really has provided a challenge to the way of Catholic thinking and Catholic cosmology. And that's, I think, because the way in which we understood the universe before modern science was not so unified. We didn't see things as unified. We sometimes saw species as really very radically different. Dogs and cats had really different sources. You know, the form of dogness and the form of catness, which in the pre-modern science philosophy was understood as defining what the species was and indeed organizing each individual dog and each individual cat, were fairly separate things, not really related in the way we would relate much more simpler things like the accidental properties of dogs. So we would sort of say, well, we understand what's going on when a dog is running along a road, or when a cat is jumping up a tree, or when a leaf falls off the tree. We would understand those things by what was called secondary causation, and modern science didn't challenge that so much, actually. But what it did do is it took those understandings of lawful behavior, things acting according to natures, which came from the Greeks, and it took that understanding of simple things in the universe and actually said, well, actually, that explains species as well. The relationship between dogs and cats was going to be explained by similar processes called natural selection and other things as well. And we started to unify things like the movement of the planets in the solar system were according to gravity, which is the same thing that causes an apple to fall off a tree. We started to unify things. There used to be a time when it was believed that angels moved planets. And if someone said, how do you know an angel existed? Well, just look at the planets moving, you know that. But of course, once we, through thinkers like Kepler, you know, we started to say that actually they are performing law-like behavior according to their natures, just in the same way leaves do and other things do, in the way what used to be called secondary causation. Then there was a challenge to the Catholic cosmology that gave a special place, for instance, to forms, both in the way things were created, species were created, and in the way we understood things. It said that we understood forms by sort of abstracting the form from an individual horse and things like that, whereas we understood lesser movements like one billiard ball hitting another or a leaf falling just by sort of repeated observation. Experimental science said, well, we understand them all that way. The form of a horse is gradually understood. So it just started to unify all these aspects of the universe in the way that Christian thought didn't find easy. Christian thought was built upon there always being this level of forms, and in which God was probably seen as the most direct cause of individual species, the forms coming into the world. And then he would use secondary causation for lower things. And science was challenging that worldview. And the extent to which Catholicism, which is quite a big extent, tried to say, no, it's not challenging that worldview. All it's doing is telling us about these lower things like efficient causation, secondary causation, it said. It's not telling us how forms came into the world. It's not really telling us how species came into the world. That led to a certain Catholic reaction against evolution, trying to say evolution is not true. Because there's no question, it is difficult to harmonize quite a bit of Thomas Aquinas's metaphysics with evolution. There's quite a few writers writing about that. So they were saying, well, surely we don't have to believe in evolution, and there became a reaction against evolution as well as other aspects of experimental science. So that's the reason I think there's less keen Catholic scientists today than there used to be, because it's been perceived by philosophers of science outside the Catholic tradition as being incompatible with Catholicism. And philosophers of science within the Catholic tradition have often not taken the impact of experimental science seriously in terms of its impact upon traditional Catholic thought. And that, therefore, has been a problem. Therefore, it's been harder to prove God, because the old proofs of God, for instance, from first cause, don't really work in an empirical universe where there's a massive emphasis upon repeated observation on things. You can't so easily jump to the universal of saying everything within the universe definitely has a cause. You can't make jumps like that so easily. And so some of these old proofs that enabled you to jump to the universal or to the general law very quickly based on an understanding of forms is not so justified anymore. So it has been a big challenge to Catholic culture, handing over the philosophy of science to those who believe that it points away from God. So we need to develop our philosophy of science in the Catholic community to revindicate our faith in the modern culture.